Confronting new video has emerged from West Papua showing Indonesian forces opening fire on Papuan protesters who appear to have their hands above their heads. The deadly shooting happened in Deiyai last week, but because of an internet shutdown in the region, details are only now surfacing. Several protesters in other parts of Indonesia have also been arrested for so-called treason.
Deadly climax in Deiyai, West Papua, after what was a peaceful protest, according to demonstrators. Video obtained by SBS appears to show Indonesian officers opening fire on West Papuan protesters. Some can be seen with their hands above their head. Sources say six bodies were found in front of the regent's office, another two in the jungle nearby. At least 15 people were wounded.
And they go inside peacefully, but suddenly, without any persuasive, police then open fire to the mass of demonstration. Then it happened, and people again, they attack with bow and arrow.
Indonesian authorities say at least one soldier was also killed in that clash, which happened last Wednesday. These photos, released the following day, appear to show the officer with several arrows lodged in his body. But the head of the local investigation unit today said the soldier was killed in a chaotic two-way gunfight, which started after demonstrators had seized guns from the army. One observer says the video simply illustrates what has been happening in the region for decades.
They've been experiencing this sort of direct confrontations and violent confrontation with the Indonesian military forces, not just recently, but also for decades. So for me, for Paniai people getting shot by the police and military is not a surprise.
An uprising which began a fortnight ago continues to see West Papuans make some of their boldest pushes for independence. In Jayapura, vision has emerged of the Indonesian flag being torn down and replaced with the Morning Star, an offence which carries a 15-year jail term. Today, many West Papuans say they're living under siege and dozens are feared missing following recent demonstrations. Internet services have now been restored in parts, allowing social media videos to trickle out. This one appears to show Indonesian civilians armed with machetes as Indonesian police look on. Activists say three West Papuan students were shot with rubber bullets, and they claim this is a common tactic used by security forces, accusing them of staging civil conflicts before armed officers move in.
The TNI and police were there, back the municipal militia to attack inside.
The fact that Indonesian government officially shut down the internet access throughout West Papua, it says a lot. Why are they doing that? What they're trying to hide.
Extra Indonesian security forces have been deployed to the region. The students who led this protest in Jakarta 10 days ago have now reportedly been arrested. A human rights lawyer says seven West Papuan students and one Indonesian person have now been arrested for treason. Others are under investigation. Virginia Langeberg, SBS World News.